Okay, as per the schedule today, we are going to discuss and learn about audit trail. So good afternoon to you all. And let's start the content or topic today. That is, today we are going to learn about ordered pair. In simply, pair means double. Okay, that means when an order is formed in a double form, that is especially considered as order pair. Let's see here on the screen. Here you can see a pair of two elements with a pair of two elements with a fixed order is known as order pair. As you can see on the screen, the definition. Okay. So as per the definition here, a pair of two elements with a fixed order is known as order pair. In the same way, we have other definitions also. So here in the other, we can define it in this way: a pair of numbers which is written in a small bracket, okay? A pair of letters which is written in a small bracket separated with comma is called order pair. Okay, as example you can see here, A comma B, that means if A and B is written in a small bracket, you can see here A and B is written in a small bracket where A and B is separated with commas. In the same way, in example two, that means in second example, there you can see one and two, which is written inside a small bracket and separated by comma. So when two number is, okay, when two number is or two element is written inside curly bracket, sorry, inside a small bracket separated by comma, such type of formations is considered as order pair. Okay, so in this way, we have here, you can see here, an order pair of two elements A and B. Listen to me very carefully. An order pair of two elements A and B is denoted by AB, which is written inside a small bracket and separated by comma. Okay, so if the elements of order pairs are written in general form like this, okay, in general form, okay, then to express such elements in the form of order pair, we should represent such elements in this form. Okay, where A is called the first component. Remind this, this type of question will be given to you for a short question. So A is called the first component or antecedent. okay, first component or answerant in the same way, B, that means this one, B is called the second component or consequent, okay? So remind this thing, the first number or the first element of the order pair are known as or considered as first component or answerant. In the same way, the second element of order pair are considered as second component or consequent. So, on the time of the question, or you may have given the question like this, define antecedent with an example. So on that time, you can define it in this way. The first component or the first element of the first element of an order pair is known as antecedent. And in the example, you can write there, in example, you can write or you can show like this. And here you can write the name and say, okay, in this way you have to write the name. So in this way, I hope you can identify the antecedent, that means the first and the second component of the order pair, that means antecedent and the consequent of the order pair, okay? Or I hope you understood how to form the order pair from the given elements. So let's talk about the other topic here. In coordinate geometry, A, B, that means the order pair AB represents a point in the Cartesian plane, okay? Especially such type of order pairs are used on Cartesian plane in coordinate geometry, where this AB is represented the distance of each and every point on the Cartesian plane, like this. Here, you can see in the picture, that is where A is called, listen to me here, when the order pair AB, when the order AB represented the point on the Cartesian plane, here, on that time, A is called Yaux coordinate or abscissa, where B is called, okay, Y coordinate or ordinate. Okay, this one we use especially while representing, okay, or showing the given order pair on graph paper, that means Cartesian plane, okay? Where the first element of the order pair is known as Yaux coordinate or abscissa, where the second element is considered as Yaux coordinate or ordinate. So be clear about this. If we talk about order pair, then the same order pair or the elements of the same order pair denotes as the first component or antecedent or the second component denotes second component as a an consequent, but this if we deal the same order pair in coordinate geometry, its name changes to x coordinate or abscissa or y coordinate or ordinate. So remind this thing. So we can say that both first element, first component, ancient, x coordinate, abscissa, these four are similar according to order pair. In the same way, second component, consequent, y coordinate, ordinate, these four are also same. Okay. So here, these are the similar name, but they pronounce or they are using as per their condition or topic. As you can see here, in example, that you can see, in example, there's given 3, 6. Which is an ordered pair where to identify the first component, that is x, that is ancient, in the same way second component, consequent, from the given order pair, we select the first element as the first component, in the same way second element as the second component, where if we represent the same thing in coordinate geometry, so the first component means x coordinate or abscissa, second component means y coordinate or ordinate. So here 3 is first component, that means ancient is equal to 3. You can see here the same as second component, consequent, is equal to 6, okay, which is the second element. And also we can represent the given order pair, in the Cartesian plane or graph. So as given us this graph here, we can also represent it. Suppose, as we know, the middle point, this one is considered as O, that means origin, which is always 0. So that the first one is 3. So as per the coordinate geometry, here 1, 2, 3. As we have learned that, here, the first component, that means the first element, is considered as x coordinate, so that we have the first number should be represented on the x coordinate. So here from 0 and 1, 2, 3, this line, and 6, that means up to 6, because the second element is considered as or denoting y coordinate. That's why we count 6 up, because the number is given in the plus form. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So here, so the point 3, 6 is represented here. Okay. So in this way, we can represent the given other pair on the graph also. As
Recording in progress.
So as we can represent the order pair on graph paper as well as on Cartesian plane too, here equality of order pair, that means this is one of the type of order pair where the first one is equality of order pair. So if we talk about order pair, this or type of order pair, equality of order pair, we can define it like this: two order pairs AB and PQ are said to be equal order pair if A is equal to P and B is equal to Q. Okay, that means this, the value of A is equal to value of P and the value of B is equal to Q, then only we can say that this AB order pair is equal to PQ order pair, otherwise, okay, no. So here you can see here in the other definition here, if the corresponding elements of two order pairs are same, then they are called equal order pairs. Okay, corresponding means the number, that means the first element of the order pair is should be equal to the first element of the second order pair. The same way, the second order pair of the second, the second element of the second order pair is equal, should be second element of the second order pair. If this type of relation is formed, then only we can say that the given order pairs are equal. In the same way, look here in the example. In the example here, you can see, and look it very carefully here. In the first order pair, there is given 2, 3. But in the second order pair, there you can see 10/5 and 6/2. are they equal or not? But here in the conclusion, it is written as are equal order pair. It means what? The given two order pairs are equal to each other. But how? So we can do like this: 5 to the 10 and 2 3 the 6. It means what? We can say that are the first element of the first order pair is 2 and the second element is 3, where also the first element of the second order pair is 2 and the second element is 3. You can see here easily or identify it easily that here you can see the both the first elements are similar. In the same way, the second elements are also similar to each other. That means we can say that the first is equal to the first and the second is equal to the second. That's why these order pairs are equal order pair. Okay. But in this time, suppose if you have given, suppose A, comma B, this is the first order pair, suppose, and other is, suppose B, A. Are they equal? No, because are the first element in the first component order pair, there is A, but in the second second order pair, there is the first element is B, which is different. In the same way, the seconds are also different. So that such type of order pairs are not equal order pair. In the same way, 1, 2, and 2, 1. Are they equal? No, because the first elements are different and also the second elements are different. That's why the given order pairs are not equal to each other. If the first element is equal to the first element and the second element is equal to the second element, then the given order pairs are considered as equal order pair. Otherwise, no. In the note, you can see here. Okay, in the note, you can see here. If we have given the order pair between or inside curly bracket like this, A, B, and B, A are same in the set. Okay, in set, we can say the two are equal because they are equal set. And to be equal set, their elements should be same and the quantity should be same. But wherever they return, that doesn't matter. But for the equality of order pair, we have the problem with the equal set, because equal sets are always different or differ from the equal order pair. So that you can see here, A comma B and B comma A are different in meaning. So we cannot write A comma B is equal to B comma A. We can write A comma B is not equal to B comma A. Okay, in the same way, if there is given A comma B and is equal to B comma A, that means we can retain only if A is equal to B. That means the value of A is equal to B, on that time only we can write this form. Otherwise we have to write not equal to. I hope you can do these type of questions. So in this way, we have completed the content today. So thank you to you all.